question is addressed to the former directors. If you have any advice or counsel for the current and future directors, this is your chance.
I would say listen to the faculty and see what they want and help them achieve what their goals are.
I would say first be inclusive, bring all the faculty, invite faculty to come to the Center for Teaching and Learning and listen to what they have to say. Usually when they come with a problem, they also bring the solution. So you have to ask, what is the solution? What do you envision as the solution? And work with them. And the other thing is to don't be afraid of recognizing the talents of those around you. They will never overcome you when you bring all the talents together and you exercise very dynamic leadership. Perhaps sometimes the best leader is not the one that goes in front, showing everybody the pathway, but the one that is very much behind, being sure that everybody is advancing. And that's what I would say, this is what my advice to the former director. Don't be afraid to be yourself. And something that Carlos and Nelson mentioned also is humanize the activity with the faculty members saying, we need to work together. We need to invite you to bring the challenges, the obstacles, and so on, and together we have to look for the solution for these problems. So,
letting others shine.
Exactly.
Love
Thank
that.
You.
Thank you. Nelson, would you have any advice?
Yes, I think that so my advice will be to keep an open line of communication with the administration. We know that we have to produce a report every year. We know that we have an operational plan and a strategic plan, and we have to be in compliance with external accreditators. So the Center for Teaching and Learning needs to produce a report every year. But the Center for Teaching and Learning needs to find that a balance between the needs to produce evidence and at the same time create that human space, as Amanda just said. And for me, it's that advice to keep convincing and building understanding of the administration about the Center for Teaching and Learning needs, identity, and that key role preserving and bringing together all faculty voices, as Amanda said. That, you know, at the end of the year, you cannot put that in the report, that you have to do it. But that's your job, to bring together all faculty members. That's my suggestion.
Thank you very much. And thank you very much to all of you for sharing your insights and wisdom. And I wish you all the best of luck as you continue to fine-tune professors and the teachers at this fine institution.
Thank you.
Thank you.